Ecco la vena. Seize the hunt. Torch emerald. I read an article about the saying that chatbots are getting dumber and dumber. Ruby, emerald. So, and there was some funny thing if you with Google search engine too. If you was it was something about you searching for in Africa, which country starts with the letter K? And the answer on Google is the first answer is there is no country with the letter K in Africa. That's the first answer you get. It's like, what the... Yeah, I know. There's a... It's like, okay. That big giant thing, dude, I was fighting. I need like a big weapon for that one. Or I need to figure out which elemental vehicle. Oh, it's like, that's a dangerous thing, you know, when an AI is learning from humans and humans are, you know, really the best people to learn, the best to learn from, I would say. just waited there. Okay, so he poisons too. Okay. Bring some Royal Manticore's lair, huh? These are pretty aggressive, these orange red ones. Yeah, but you know, that requires effort from them. Ah, shit, me. What the heck is that exit out of this damn place, man? That's what I'm trying to figure out. I'm trying to get them to kill themselves on the traps down below. The only other way out of here is just these stupid doors with the gems, but I don't have any gems anywhere. Oh, yeah, this way. Yeah, no, this was a dead end. Yes, I need... Maybe I need to mine. Oh yeah, I have to mine those things, so maybe I get one again. Probably it. Annoying. Come on, what the? Thank you. Oh, that right there. Way up here. You can see. Seems I have taken any damage from this. The traps. So it's probably immune to physical damage. Let's see what we come out at. Okay, so that needs Emerald and Ruby. I wonder what you need for that manticore. Wanna try and fight it? Clutchy fingers pressing the wrong button. Not sleep with the fishes, I'm gonna sleep with the butterflies. Need some more skills. You are very thirsty. Yeah, we're gonna run by this stupid big giant thing then. But yeah, it needs some elemental damage, I just don't know which. I have to test out later. What in the freaking heck is that thing? Just looting, okay. Where are some? That thing is probably, will probably wreck us pretty quick. I'm kind of curious what's inside there. Another one of these enemies in here. Mm-hmm. Time to see if we can run. Dead body, corpses over there, but I don't have any room right now, so. You need to get back to town or, under. That one I have to dodge fight. And block him was just too much, just too big hits for me to handle. Alright, so the Royal Manticore is over there. Whatever that damn weird thing is. I wonder if I need a Royal Manticore tail later for the quest. So we need to figure out what that enemy has for weakness, elemental weakness. The Manticore down there has ranged attacks. See one of the vendors around. I should probably drop the alchemy and the cauldron in the city. Pretty stupid to carry them around at the moment. Trading dinner, I will have to cook soon.
How can I help you?
So let's see.
Thank you.
Okay, let's see. Done. And I need to stop some of stuff. All this. Plus, money is what I need right now. Get more skills.
How can I help you?
I Why is it a waste for much of all this? Old stones waste a lot. Mana stones, they weigh a lot. Damn. There's some. We have 7, so 1600, so we have enough to go and do some upgrading of skills. But I have a little bit more to explore in this area though. Oh, let's see if there's a mistake. What else weighs a lot? Potion, I guess. And these tea. Wood. Pam 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 pam. Okay. Gotta leave the area to see. Just gonna get some water to drink, I'll be right back. Okay, so Royal Manticore and some weird looking creature. Right now, it's just a good idea to run around and Loot. Get money to buy skills. Kill these things.
Greetings, friend.
It is actually a weapon, giant iron key. And this is needed for one of the doors in there. Still wondering where the petrified wood is at. Normal wood. Thank you. Bandit camp, huh? Actually, do I need to do that now? And cold is the best against that one. Here we go. The final goal. I don't know. There is a, you have to, the thing is, you're supposed to pick a faction and help them. Do a chain or quest for them. But I'm trying to gear up because I read the faction quests are timed. Which is kind of dumb in my opinion, but I'm trying to get skills and stuff like that, just to make it easier for me. You probably don't need it, but I just like to be prepared. Yeah, exactly. So you can do all kinds of stuff right now. There are some quests you can do and so on. Otherwise, it's pretty much explore, do dungeons. Yeah, I know that. He already has all that. We follow bonus petty. Okay. Good place. Yeah, this is a definitive addition. I have the DLCs for both of them. Yeah, good luck with your mage, rune mage. Thanks for stopping by. You have a good one. Good luck with your game. But the combat in this game is kind of a pretty rough in some aspect. You can almost say it's like but it's kind of like a bit of a Dark Souls style. How it works. You have like no idea about the enemies. They can be a physical immunity and you have to use a certain element to do any damage to them, but you have like no idea which one it is. You have like 5 different elements to pick from. Like, yeah, good luck finding out which one it is it's immune against. Yeah, but in Elix you get information at least, you know. Here you get nothing. So you start whacking at a big huge enemy in a dungeon or whatever, and it's like you do no damage. Then it's like, yeah, okay, good luck trying out all the different elements to what it does, what damage it takes. It's like much, a lot of, you know, trial and error. And as you die a lot in this game, where you end up at is random. You can end up back in the city. You can end up in a dungeon somewhere. You can end up in a bandit camp if you they capture you. You can end up in a prison. That is a lot of weirdness. But when you die, you can get punished really hard, or you can be like, oh, not that much happened. Then the problem is you have a backpack. And can't really dodge with this backpack. There are certain backpacks you can use. I have one. I'm not using it because it's so small. Storage wise. Not using it. So, because some enemies use magic close by, and if you don't dodge away, you will take full on damage unless you have like a certain skill that can pretty much just take it. You take it over. It's a difficult game in many aspects. Depends on how much you want to do in the game. There's like tons of different builds for the game, and if you want to do melee, do you want to be a caster? Do you want to be a ranged? Yeah. And then, depending on the weather, like in the desert, you have to have certain armor to handle heat. Then there is the starting area, that one has snow sometimes. Then you have to have clothes that handles cold. Otherwise, you can get a cold in the game. You can freeze, and the same thing with the heat, and then you get debuffs, and yeah. The game is very complex in many ways, and there is like extremely little information you get in the game. Extremely little. So to learn, it's either test it out, hope it works. If it doesn't, yeah. Then it's like, yeah. Test is over. Start over again. This is the come back to that valley. Yeah, here is like some sandals. You can wear sandals and some specific desert armor. Sandals to eat. There is also a... I don't have it on me now, but... going to the desert, but that torch that cools you down. In this game, you also have to keep track of your water and food and then if you get poison, you can get different sick diseases and like so many different things. If you don't have, you know, something to manage it to disease, then it's like, yeah, good luck. Then he has a massive crafting system too. But not a big one. I don't know if you would call it a big problem or not, but you start in this starting city, and you have a player house there, a house for you, where you can store stuff in a big chest and it never goes away. But you have no housing in the other cities unless you do join their faction, or I think you can then later on buy the houses in the other areas. So I have no place to store my gear really right now in this area. I can drop it in the city and I hope it doesn't despawn. But right now what I'm doing, I'm just exploring, looting as much as possible, yet making money. Because the skills in this game, you have to go to the different big cities in each area. And then there are trainers there where you have to buy the skills from. But then comes a limitation. You're only, when you get the highest skills, you're only allowed to use three skills. Threes. Out of, I think it's like 10. Yeah, it is kind of like that in this one, but then. But in an RPG instead. Have all these limitations. So when you try out things in this game, you can have to be very, very careful, because you can easily end up dying and then then you have your nasty debuffs, and you have your, like, your main health is lowered, and yeah, I know. I mean, you can mod this game. There are mods, a lot of mods for this game, so you can remove a lot of these limitations. There's also so you can fast travel between all the cities and stuff like that. You look like a big nasty guy. Maybe you be. I assume you're hostile, right? I mean, I don't mind some realists, but there are, you know, limits to. Sometimes it's like it goes too far, you know? Well, that Hiena is gonna attack that dude. Yeah, good luck, Hiena. I mean, there's a lot of people who like that kind of difficulty to them, so. Here's to see how popular the Dark Souls games are, you know. I like this kind of game because I love exploring. That's why I love RPGs, where you can, you know, explore a lot and find some cool stuff. We are gonna do a little quick look up here. Maybe go back to Berg. Gonna be interested to see what this looks like. Let me have this area too. But I have enough money to go to Honsu now and get my warrior monk skills I want. Yeah, I mean, learning stuff like that in a game is fine. There's some stealth games that we also have to like learn how to stealth from scratch. And first, you can only stealth one way, then you have to learn more skills, and then you can properly sneak around. Those games are fun though, because then you have a progress of your character. Procedures done on him too, though. Necklace camp. Okay, let's get back to Berg. To dismantle a thing of them. dangerous thing with this type of game though is time flies. Like, I just want to check out the one thing. Are they actually fighting up there now? Like, yeah, I'm just gonna check out that place. I'm just gonna check out that place. So this was not that bad. See what these things are and that one. I killed one of those things already. Slap it there, but he jumped away from me. That's what we need for a quest, I think. Attacking me more than I should have there. He has jumped away from me constantly. Then this game has like, the more you use, like, you know, your stamina, or then if you lose your health, you lose your max stamina and max health. On the yellow bar down there, it's like kind of grayish yellow. It's like stamina I can't use. It's spent or burnt. It's called burned stamina. But otherwise, you have to take a potion to regain it, or you have to rest, get it back. So when you're fighting, that can become a problem. Thank you. There's like a lot of different things to think about in this game. Then it has a weird way how you get mana in the game for your character. You have to sacrifice a certain amount of health and stamina to get the mana. And the more mana you want, the more health and stamina you lose.
Greetings, friend. Or was it just health?
I think it was only health, if I remember it. It's a lot of weirdness. Why are these so worth so much? Yeah, it does. It's just that you need to like read the check on the look it up on the internet what certain things do and what it does and how you get things and where do you need to go for that thing and. The only thing I have a little bit of critique about in this game is the corruption, as it's called. Because the starting area, there's like two places you can go to. And it has corruption in them. Well, there's also in the bottom of a dungeon and and inside a crypt. Ruins. And it adds up a stack of, and then you, depending how much you, if you go 100%, then you get a debuff on you. You get 100% again, you get an, worse debuff, but it also has its benefit. But it also is the only way to remove that debuff. Either you have to go to the DLC area and it costs you 200 silver one way and to go to that city. Then you have to buy the stuff to get rid of it, which is another few hundred and all that. Depending how much you need to get rid of. But then you need to pay another 200 silver to get back, you know. But luckily they added some small potions that removes like 20% of it. So I didn't have much luckily, but still it's like. I think it's kind of shitty. In a way, since it isn't really explained unless you look it up. Then it makes it like, should I go into those areas at all and explore, or should I just ignore them, or what's the deal? Because then it's more like, just as well skip them. It just makes it so you don't want to go there. So it kind of ruins the... For me, it kind of ruins the purpose, you know? Like, don't come to this area until you're proper know how to play the game or stuff like that. I mean, many areas in this game, like dungeons stuff, you can just go in and just run around. Block. It depends on you don't mind trying to avoid everything that tries to hit you, but you know. Like right now, my heat, I'm getting warmer and warmer because I stand by this one, because my armor has minus hot weather defense. I like this, that they can have like an alchemy kit and, you know, and a cooking pot. Make more advanced dishes when you're running around. You can do simple dishes without it, but... so where is... Okay, now we need to sleep. And then you have repairing too. Gain enough stamina, or if I need to sleep more. I like this tempter because it gives you a buff afterwards. Okay. Let's go explore some more. Chill, man. Vendor up here.
Want to buy something?
I don't want to buy something, I want to sell stuff. Well, that's another thing. You only have these 8 slots down there to put your skills and items in. Unless you mod it. I think there was a mod that adds more. Well, probably another thing I would say would be nice to have had. We can switch. More ethereal enemies. Denied. Hey, Yes, after a certain amount of time they do respawn. And also loot and chests and stuff like that respawns after a certain amount of time too. I think it's like a week in the game. Stuff respawns. So like in the first starting, and I figure out a way where I can just run and loot stuff. I made in the end we got up to 900 silver just running and looting stuff. But then it turned out I missed a place. In the end I think we had like 1200 silver. Okay, so let's see now. So one goes up. Yeah, by the wind. So, certain places, you know, when you've been running through them and you have used levers and stuff like that. Doors tend to be open and you get keys, so certain places, if you just bring the keys with you, you can just run through and just go for the loot, just ignore all the enemies. But then you also have to think, this game, there is different things that can happen at night and daytime too. Things change depending on night and day. Like some stuff you can only see and loot during nighttime and so on. And so it's this resting place. Oh, this sounds like it's gonna be a horrible place to visit right now. The Moonlight Artifact? Oh, I can't remember that one. Read. Here rests the spirit of the ancients. Go forth with respect and good intentions. Such a weird angle. Could use the boon.
What the heck? Quick. That was close. That was a little bit scary. Silly Archer. Like something is running above. Thank you. Sounds sounds in feature. This place, there's a lot to explore. Now we need to really empty my bag for this place. Could toss a grenade maybe over and see if this key opens this door. I could probably run in and open. Oh. Man. Let's come back to this place. I think I know what I can do there. I have to run in and open that door, and then depending how I can kite the enemies, I might be able to open that chest. Stalker game, and they have a lot of mods, those. It'll be interesting now with Stalker 2, though. I just hope people don't, you know, have too high hopes on the game. I mean, it's better to be pleasantly surprised than how good it is. Because they haven't had the best, you know, environment to work in, so to say, you know.
you.
Ah, that one is worth 300. Interesting looking one.
How can I help you?
Just for anything. Just wondering if we shouldn't keep this one for when we run around. The loot thing.
Want to buy something?
Yeah, I want to buy gold bars. There we go. Good way to keep your stuff safe, your money safe, for certain enemy or at least bandits, so they can take your money. So, I think we're pretty much set to go back to the main city and run up to Monsoon and buy all the skills we need. I still want to run through that place up there and see if I can just open the door there or not. It's too late now. Okay.